Mario, Ruby, let's go.
Come on, let's have a candid conversation. Let's talk about it. Just bring it up with your hope and love.
Yeah.
It's all about you and you will be the candid conversation show. Let's go. Let's talk
Come
about
on.
It.
Hey.
Welcome back to Let's Talk About It, the Candid Conversation Show. My name is Muriel.
And my name is Ruby.
And on the show, we discuss topics that are unspoken and taboo in our community. Our guest tonight is our big brother, John Bissainthe. He is a musician, former customer relations, and a survivor. We will be discussing his life with hydrocephalus, depression, and beating the odds.
John, welcome to the show.
Welcome.
Thank you both for having me here today.
About time, right?
It's time. It's time. We know this is
time to tell my story.
Yes, it is time to share your story. We know that it's going to impact, and we know that it's going to inspire so many people out there. This show is very personal to us because you are our big brother. And we always lead the show with asking the guests to tell us a little bit about their childhood, because we believe that's who shapes us to who we become as adults. Can you share a little something?
Well, I want to thank you for inviting me to the show, Muriel and Ruby.
You're welcome.
You're welcome.
I was the oldest of four kids, and I was the sickliest one of four kids. My aunt discovered at 2 months of age that my eyes were rolling behind my head.
Mm-hmm.
And they took me to the doctor. My parents took me to the hospital and found out that I had fluid built up in the brain.
Okay.
Which was a very traumatic thing for them. Being the oldest child,
mm-hmm.
they did not know how to handle this situation.
Of course.
But one of the nurses said something she should have never told him.
Mm.
She told him that y'all are a young couple. If he doesn't make it, you can always have other kids.
Yeah. Who says that to somebody?
That was a nurse that didn't care. She didn't have any kids.
That's sad.
But I understood. She didn't have any kids, so she didn't sympathize with my parents at that time.
Right.
She's in the wrong field.
Yeah. So she does that, and then parents said, okay, well, we'll go ahead and have the operation if it's going to save his. Right, so
mm-hmm.
we went and had the operation,
mm-hmm.
which they had a shunt in there, which is a tube that goes inside the go down the spinal cord to help the fluid build, so the fluid doesn't build up in your. That was a very traumatic thing for them mm-hmm. at 2 months of age to have to go through that.
So we have to tell the viewers what it is. What is hydrocephalus? It's referred to as water on the brain. The definition is the buildup of fluid in the ventricles deep within the brain. The excess fluid increases in size of the ventricles and puts pressure on the brain.
That is correct. That is correct.
Mm-hmm.
So I dealt with that. And on top of that, I had issues walking, so they had to break both of my legs.
Okay. Mm.
So I started walking at a late age, stage of my life.
Mm-hmm.
They had to put the brace, boot on.
Mm-hmm.
Some people call it the dummy boot with a bar in the middle.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So I'll never forget that boot.
Yeah.
It was a white boot.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So I had to wear that for a while and sleep with it.
Okay.
My mom had to crank it at night to adjust it.
Adjust
for me to
mm-hmm.
sleep.
Right.
And so I had to wear that thing all the time, which was not. I didn't know how it was comfortable or if it was not comfortable because I was of a young age. So
you
I
were too
know.
Young.
Right.
But that's what I had to deal with. And then they dealt with it. It wasn't easy, but they dealt with it.
Right.
So
how do you think that they felt?
What
do you think was going through their head as this being their first child?
Mm-hmm.
What do you think? How do you think they felt that here they are having to deal with a child with a disability?
Well, I'm putting myself in their shoes. They probably said, why me, Lord? Why am I going through this? My first child. I've done nothing but good.
Mm-hmm.
And here I am with a child that came into this world sick.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So that really affected them a lot.
Did they tell you that when you became an adult that it bothered them?
Oh, yes. As I got of age where I could understand, they did tell me that.
Mm.
It did bother me that they had to go through that,
being
that I was the first child. But, you know, they dealt with it pretty good. They try not to show no no remorse over the whole situation.
Right, but so they wanted...
They did pretty good.
Right. One thing I always remembered is that they treated you, I mean, even though you're our older brother, they treated you as...
Just like us.
Just like we were treated. Mm-hmm. Like there was nothing wrong. You know, they did give you a little bit more TLC, of course, but we all did.
Yeah, that was true, but at the same point, I did talk to my parents when I became of age. I said, I don't want to be treated any different because I have a handicap. They treat me like you treat the rest of them.
Right.
So they treated me just like they treated you other three, which was greatly appreciated. I didn't want no special privileges because I came in a handicap.
Right. Yeah. Well, we all gave you a little TLC, though.
Right.
Oh, yeah. And don't think it goes unnoticed. It does not go unnoticed.
Yeah.
I appreciate that.
So how were your school years, though? Elementary, how do you remember any key moments?
School was not easy for me. Mm-hmm. It was not easy for me, starting with elementary all the way up to the end of high school. Yeah. I was picked on a lot, laughed at.
Yeah, because they didn't understand.
It was very hard for me. It affected my studies a lot.
Of course.
Because I did get picked on a lot, and because of my head function, because I didn't pick up like everybody else did.
Of course.
So they did laugh at me and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. I had all kind of names, which I won't say on the air, but I had all kind of names that they gave me.
Yeah, but, right. We know.
So that really affected me a lot too.
Right.
It affected me. I got into a couple fights. But
that's understandable.
Look,
we got into a couple fights too.
I know,
we?
Right?
Yeah. Yes, y'all did.
Breaking glasses, punching people in the face. Everything.
They called me four eyes and everything because I had to wear glasses because every time I go into a surgery, my vision changes.
It gets affected.
My vision changes.
But kids are so mean. It's just kids are just bullies.
Yeah, they are cruel this day, and it's just getting worse and worse.
Yeah.
It's getting worse and worse. So, you know, you just got to learn how to deal with it. Even as an adult now, when I go to the store, I still get the stare down.
But how do you take that?
I have to get in their face sometimes. I have to get in their face.
Yeah, I think it's so rude. Sometime. Yeah.
Right. Because people don't understand. They think that the whole world looks exactly like them. They don't understand when somebody looks a little bit different.
They don't understand that.
That you're fighting for your life. You know.
As a matter of fact, I went to a store one time. Mm-hmm. It was a Haitian market. Mm-hmm. They didn't know that I was Haitian.
Oh boy!
So they started talking about me. Mm-hmm.
You responded in Creole.
And I turned around and told them to their face in French. I'm not gonna say it in French. I said, "Why don't you put a muzzle on your mouth?"
Oh shoot,
oh, Lord!
You put a muzzle on your mouth because you never know who's around you.
And who understands the language?
They were so embarrassed about it.
Right.
And they said, "Oh, I'm so sorry." So I said, "Well, it's too late now. You already said it."
Say it in Creole. I want to hear you. Say it in Creole. That's a good one. But sometimes that's what you have to do.
You got to put them in their place.
It stopped them and shocked them, didn't it?
You have to put them in their place.
Yeah.
I call it.
They shocked them because they didn't know that I was a Haitian.
Right.
Of Haitian descent.
That's right.
Well, I'm Haitian. That's right. But you got a problem with that?
Oh, God.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness.
So yeah. But you fought many battles, didn't you? You had to fight a lot. It's a constant fight. Yeah.
I call that no home training. That's what I call it. NHT. Because it starts at home, the parents.
That's exactly what it is. No home training whatsoever.
Yeah. We didn't grow up that way. We were taught
that. Our parents always told us to sympathize with others.
Absolutely.
That's got a handicap. Don't laugh at them. If they get you laugh at them, they're gonna smack you.
Yeah, you never know how you're gonna end up. So why would you make fun of somebody else?
It can because it can happen to anyone. It's not like they chose.
I never make fun of anybody. I just I just let them because I've got a disability, so I just. Right. Let them do their thing.
And not only it can happen to anyone. It's not like they chose to have a child that had a disability. It can happen to anyone.
But you know, I was doing some research and I saw that hydrocephalus can happen at any age. You know that. It's not just from birth.
Oh, I didn't know.
I was surprised.
A head injury, meaning you'd have to have a head injury?
You don't have to have a head injury. Even if you're elderly, you can get it. Yeah, I was surprised.
You don't have to have it at birth.
Yes.
I did some research on it also, and they found out that you do not have to have it at birth. You could be at any age.
At any age, and there's no cure.
You could be 80 years old and have hydrocephalus.
Absolutely. Okay. Yeah. So that's what I'm saying regarding people talking about. You never know. what can happen to you.
So hydrocephalus doesn't discriminate. On
no,
age.
It doesn't.
When it comes to the age, it does not discriminate.
Right.
Yeah.
So how is it that you're dealing with it? Tell us how you deal with this on a daily basis. How is it?
Well, thank God I have a loving wife, and she's there for me.
Thank God.
So she's there. She's my support, and that gives me courage. And
yes.
I had to go to therapy. Excuse me for a minute. I had to go to a counseling group.
Okay.
It's a support group.
Right.
I had to go to a support group for a while, and then I went there for like 3 years.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good.
But it was to the point where it wasn't doing nothing for me.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And it also got to the point where the ones that are supposed to be supporting me were making fun of me.
Oh, no.
Oh, that's awful.
Yeah, we're in a support group. We're supposed to support each other.
Right.
But instead of supporting me with my illness, making fun of me.
Oh, no.
So I dropped the support group.
Right, I would have done the same.
I didn't associate with them no more, so
yeah.
I just stopped doing
that
it
all. That is so sad.
Correct. But have you found another group or a therapist, one-on-one, that you can go to?
No. I just keep myself busy so the depression doesn't kick in.
Okay.
And then it helps me a lot when I take my pills on a daily basis, so that helps the situation a lot, too.
Okay.
Keeps me going. Yeah, I do a lot of things on the computer and my music and stuff. I keep my music going.
So It keeps me active. Okay.
It keeps me active. So with that, I talk to a lot of people too. So, which y'all know, I like to talk.
Right.
I talk to a lot of people back in Florida.
Good. So, that's good. They're waiting on you to come back.
We're all waiting for you to come back.
Oh, yeah. Well, they just can't wait. They said, when are you coming back? When are you coming back? I said, give me time. It'll happen. Give me time. Yeah, give me time. But, I still talk to a lot of people from Arizona that I work with. I had a good support team in Arizona.
Very good.
At work. They would not let me walk out by myself. I have to walk out with somebody. They said, John, you're not walking out by yourself. So they grabbed me like I was a little old man.
Right. Well, they gave you TLC as well. That was TLC. I said they were giving you TLC as well.
Oh, they love me some. They love them some John.
Those are people that are compassionate. They're just compassionate people.
Yes.
And they just want to help.
They love them some John. And we still keep in touch till this day.
Mm-hmm, that's awesome.
Yeah, we talk on Facebook and we talk, we get FaceTime.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So we keep in contact with each other. So that's a good support thing.
So you're able to walk now? You're walking, but you're using a walker?
I'm using a rollator, which is like a walker.
Okay.
When I get tired, I just sit in it.
Yeah. Oh, okay. You got the seat there. Okay.
Yeah, I got to sit there and get myself together, and then I get up and walk again.
Mm-hmm.
But don't let the rollator fool you. I still get up in the kitchen and cook my Haitian food sometimes.
That's good.
Some Haitian stuff, I can get up and cook it.
Boy, I'm waiting on that rice and beans.
I know, right? A mean rice and beans.
Yeah. Yeah, I know everybody's waiting for that one. I do some cooking at the house. I'm the breakfast king in the morning.
So oh, that's great.
I do the breakfast, yeah. So I keep myself busy, so I don't.
Good.
I don't go into straight depression.
Right.
Yeah. So
that's
a
good thing. I'm glad you do.
Like I said, my wife keeps me occupied, so
very
I don't
good.
Go into depression.
That's good.
Yeah. So that's a good thing.
Question for you. So what are the doctors saying? First of all, how many surgeries?
Mm-hmm.
Let's talk. Let's let the viewers know how many surgeries have you had to have.
I've had five shunt revisions.
Okay.
And the last one was done 20 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And what is the reason why they keep doing these revisions?
Because I get fluid built up in the brain, I get memory losses, and then my vision gets blurry.
Okay.
That's when I know it's not working right.
So you can tell, you can feel it.
Oh, I can feel it. Mm-hmm. I can feel it when it's not working right. So I have to get it done.
Okay.
Yeah, but. Yeah, that's the way I'm button. Knock on wood, I haven't had no problem with it. I go check out every so often.
Okay.
Everything's good.
That's good.
Everything's good.
I know the last one, they put it real close to the front. Can you tilt your head just a little forward? Tilt it a little forward. They see it. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Can you see
it's
it?
It's the shunt that's going down.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. To drain the fluid.
That's been in over 20 years now.
It's about time for it to be removed or no? To change?
No. Like I said, when I get headaches, blurred vision, memory lapses.
I know. Wow.
Yeah.
That's a long time.
That's when I know it's time.
Oh, my goodness.
But I just had it checked the other day,
Very
a couple
good.
Months ago.
Okay.
Everything is good.
Awesome.
So I said, thank you, Lord, for that, because I don't want to go through that again.
No.
Exactly. Yeah.
So
it's not a good recovery. Recovery, because I have staples in my head when I have to do it.
It's true. Okay. Okay. Van. Yeah, I remember.
Mm-hmm. And they have to pull them out.
Yeah.
With the hair growing in.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Do you feel that you have memory issues? I know sometimes you'll forget.
Oh yes. I still have memory issues. It's not as bad as it used to be, but it's there.
Okay.
It's still there. And that's probably something I'm going to have to live with for the rest of my life.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. What? Some things I remember like it was yesterday, and some things it's just a big blur.
Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah.
Yes. Sometimes I don't remember what happened 5 minutes ago.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
Well, look, I have that problem as well, so. I have that problem as well. It's called old age. Yeah, we're getting old.
I don't know if it's old age or what's going on, but that's what happened.
Uh-huh.
My wife's memory is better than mine some days.
Uh-huh.
I'm like, oh, my goodness, yeah. But that's okay. We're here. We support each other.
That's right.
We support each other.
Exactly.
Yeah, we support each other.
So, question for you: What are the doctors saying? What is your prognosis? Is the dragging of the legs the reason that why you need to have a walker? Is that having to do with this? Does that have anything to do with your disability, your condition?
Okay. Well, with the leg dragging, mm-hmm. that started when I had the mini stroke in 2001.
Okay.
It got better with therapy,
mm-hmm.
you know, and I still do exercises at home to keep it going.
Okay.
But as you get older, things get worse. It's harder to function with things. So it's hard for me to walk now without a walker.
Okay.
I used to use a cane.
Mm-hmm.
I stopped using the cane because I did fall one time with the cane. So I said, well, I got to go to a rollator, as much as I hate to do it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, you have to.
I didn't like doing it, but I had to do what I had to do.
Right.
Yeah. And I know your driving was also impacted. You're no longer driving as well.
Yes, that started in 2019.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, 2019 when I my reflexes were bad.
Mm-hmm.
By the time I hit the brakes on the right leg, it's too late.
My God.
You already into.
I rear-ended another car.
Right.
So
it's time to stop.
So that's when it's made a decision to stop. It's time to stop now.
Yeah. Right.
To save my life and save somebody else's life.
Exactly.
So,
well, at least you realize that, though, because there are some people
that'll keep driving.
They will keep driving.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so that's good.
Yeah,
that
I gave
you
up
made
my
that
license
decision.
Gracefully. So
yeah.
Mm-hmm.
No. Yeah. So she's happy about it. I'm not too happy about it, but she's happy. About it.
You're home
she can,
now.
She can control where you go.
Typical woman, huh?
That's too much control
lose,
if you ask
part,
me.
You
but
lose part of your independence when you ask somebody to take you somewhere.
Uh-huh.
Exactly.
But that's okay. She doesn't mind taking me when she
Yeah, comes, that's you know, so nice.
That's good. Yeah,
so backtrack, though. The reason for the stroke, does that have to do with
the shunt? Maybe or
No, it wasn't the shunt.
Okay.
The stroke happened while I was sleeping.
But what were the reasons? What did they say?
It was a TIA, a mini stroke.
Okay.
But it affected the left side.
Okay.
Okay. The left side of my body.
Okay.
You know, it's better than what it was because it even affected my speech at one point, but it's better than what it was.
Okay.
You know, I still have little issues with it, but it's, you know, I deal with it. I learned how to deal with it. At least I can lift my hand up now.
Okay.
The left side.
For
I can
therapy.
Lift my leg up. I have to force it to get up sometimes.
Right. Keep moving it.
I can do
it.
Yeah, keep
keep
moving it.
I just keep pushing it, you know, just keep doing what I got
to
do.
Mm-hmm. Do you have to still use the electrodes on your back?
No, I stopped using those because after a while they don't do nothing for you.
Okay.
Use them for 2 months.
Okay.
Yeah, every once in a while I'll take some painkillers.
Mm-hmm.
Then again, after you take them for so long, it doesn't do nothing for you. So
isn't that something?
I don't take them that often as I used to.
But what type of pain are you feeling? What type of pain?
Pardon me?
Where? What type of pain?
It's in the back, up in the spine.
Right.
I've also got spinal stenosis.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, so with the curvature of the spine, and
mm-hmm.
sometimes when you're walking in, it's bone rubbing on bone almost.
Right,
oh my goodness.
So I've got that going on also.
And you won't do surgery on that, will you?
What's that?
You won't have any surgery on that, will you?
No, told me, I went to two places. They told me if I do surgery, I'll be in a wheelchair. So I'm not ready for that yet.
Yeah,
right. Yeah. Right, we'll try to deal with it as best as you can.
So I just deal with it.
Right.
Know?
Yeah, because
it's a 24-hour pain.
Oh my goodness.
Mm-hmm.
24-hour pain, so I just deal with it.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't dwell on it.
Yes.
I just keep myself moving so I don't, you know, if I stop too much and think about it, I go crazy. So I stop thinking about it like that.
Mm-hmm.
I just keep doing what I have to do.
Keep having faith. You have to have faith. Yeah,
that's good.
You got to.
Well, your music helps you. The music definitely helps you.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I keep myself busy with the music, you know, mm-hmm. and the piano, organ.
That's right. Yeah.
You know what, though, I think? Yeah. Even if, because I know our parents, we had piano lessons as well. All of us had piano lessons. But mm-hmm. it was just a gift that you, it was just a natural gift for you. Because we never really, I mean, we play the piano, but it wasn't something that we really liked.
Yeah.
But for you, you don't even need music. You just play.
No. Right.
Well, music, since I was a kid, my parents always told me that I was always into the music. So, you know, that came up pretty easy for me.
Mm-hmm.
Like you said, I play by ear a lot.
That's right.
I read music, and I play at weddings and churches. So I keep myself busy with that, you know, that way I don't dwell on other things. It keeps my mind going.
Right.
It keeps my mind going.
And you also do prison ministry. You used to. I don't know if you still do.
What's that?
Prison
ministry?
Mm-hmm.
I did the prison ministry for 5 years when I was in Orlando.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and it was good to see people from all walks of life.
Yeah.
And then they really enjoyed our ministry over there.
Mm-hmm.
But there come a time, like everything else, you know, you got to learn how to walk away from things. Because after a while, it was taking over.
Yeah.
With my everyday life.
Okay.
You know, so I stopped doing that. Yeah.
Well, you did your good deed with that.
I enjoyed it. I enjoyed it while it lasted.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's awesome. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I used to go to the one in Sanford.
Okay.
Yeah.
That is great.
Now, I know you mentioned depression. I suffer with depression as well. So how did you know that you were suffering with depression, and when did you seek help? How many years has it been for you?
Well,
what were you feeling?
I started noticing it like maybe 15, 20 years ago.
Mm.
20 years, maybe, let's say 20 years ago now.
Okay.
I started noticing that I had every little thing would get me going, get me off. So I said, wait a minute, something's wrong here.
Mm-hmm.
And then I went to the doctor, and I was telling the doctor about it. The doctor said, you probably need to be on some kind of medication. So they put me on the depression medication.
Okay.
You know, it helps.
But it makes you sleepy.
You know, because if you think about it, I have a lot to be depressed about. But with the illness and stuff that I got going on. But I can't take it out on other people because it's not their fault.
No.
Correct.
Yeah, it's not their fault.
Mm-hmm.
Some people take their stuff out on people that have nothing to do with it.
Right. Yeah. Right.
So, but
that's
I don't function that way.
Right. That's
I try not to function that way because even at work, they say they don't know how I did
it. Yes. Because they wouldn't be able to deal with it. Everyone's different. You learn how to deal with it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. They come to work in the morning. They're mad because a car cut them off. I'm like, are you serious? I said, are you serious?
Yes, the little things. You know, I have to commend you, though. Mm-hmm. I always, anybody asks me about you, I always say, he's such a sweet guy. You're so compassionate.
Is.
You're so sweet. You're a servant leader. You're always doing good for others.
It's true.
So I have to commend you on that. I really,
right.
I can't say nothing bad about you.
And I appreciate that coming from my sisters. And when I do these things, I don't expect nothing in return.
Exactly.
Yeah, we know that.
I don't expect
so
nothing
humble.
In return. And like I said, I don't expect for people to feel like, look at him. He's handicapped. And he's doing this for this person and doing that for that person.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, sometimes you just do it. It's just
that's
natural.
It. From
you're
your
so
heart.
Humble.
It's
just
natural.
Yeah. You never. Natural. There's never a day that I've heard you say, "Poor me, poor me, mm-mm. poor me." You never.
He probably felt it, but he never said it.
He never let it out his mouth.
You know. Sometimes sometimes I'm pretty good at hiding how I feel.
I call it the mask. You know, that's what I call it.
Yeah, I could put that mask on and nobody would ever
there you go.
Put my
right.
game face on.
Because you know how to do it now. After how many years? 55 years? 54 years?
You're just putting him all out there.
55 years.
55 years.
55 years.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so I've been dealing with this stuff for a long time.
Yeah.
Well, you sure look good.
You look great. But how do you really feel? You look great, but how do you feel?
Mm-hmm.
Well, like I said, I'm always in pain.
Yeah.
I feel good. But
okay.
Like I said, I don't let the pain get to me. I'm always in pain.
Mm-hmm.
24 hours, 7 days a week, you know, but I just try to keep going. If I don't keep going, I'll get into depression. So I try not
and pray, and pray, and pray.
Yep. Right.
Oh, yeah. We stay prayed up.
That's right. That's right.
Well, my last wish for you is that Dorothy will say to herself, we're going to move back. We're going to move to Orlando where John can be around his friends and his family because that is your support. I understand she's a support as well, but that's her. That's just her.
That's true.
You've got a whole village here that loves you and will welcome you back at any time.
Oh, yeah. If when I come to Orlando, it'll be like the president coming into town.
Exactly.
Yes. President Bissainthe.
Everybody wants to see John.
I know. Oh, my goodness. That's right. John. They're going to roll out the red carpet.
Yeah. It's like, where y'all going to meet me at?
That's right. That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, John, I remember that every single family trip that we take, you do not participate in, which it totally kills me because I want you to enjoy yourself, you know, and enjoy your life.
Right.
But you always say that you don't want the public scrutiny. You don't want all the people staring at you and you don't want to make it bad for us.
So I still have that problem.
Yeah.
I still have that problem till this day. I still have that problem because it might end up being physical. And I don't want to spoil.
Right. I don't think it would because
he's not meaning from his end. He's meaning from the group.
Yeah. I think it would be okay. I really do.
Yeah.
Because there are so many people with handicaps and I understand you just see yourself, but we
Especially
really want to take.
I come back, I'm on a walker.
Yeah. That's okay. It's okay. Look, we'll be first in. Yeah. They'll let us in first.
That's right.
Yeah, I think it'll be fine. We just want to have that family vacation with you.
Yeah,
let you enjoy
some of the memories.
We gotta make it happen.
Awesome. Right. I'm so excited.
So that way you're not always looking at everybody else in pictures. You'll be looking at yourself in the picture as well.
Yeah, we would love that.
Exactly. Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Can you tell me if you feel anxious when you're out in public? You feel anxious?
Depends on what kind of day I'm having.
Okay.
Some days I'm good. Some days I'm like, I feel like an old man. I feel like an 80-year-old some days.
Oh, boy.
I feel like that too, though, sometimes. I do.
Every day is different.
Yeah. Right.
Depending on what kind of day I'm having.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And the weather has a lot to do with it too sometimes.
Yes, it's true. Yeah, it's very true.
Yeah.
Do you feel that as children growing up, do you feel that we treated you fairly? Do you feel that we were a good support for you?
To be honest with you, sometimes I was embarrassed because y'all treated me so like I was, you know. It was a good feeling, but it was also an embarrassing feeling because it's like I can't reciprocate like I wanted to reciprocate, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so it was very difficult for me to accept, you know. But I appreciate it.
Yeah, we just wanted to support you.
All three of you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
we know it was tough. We know it was tough because I remember, matter of fact, elementary, I know the person's name, but I'm not saying it. Him having the dog chase after you on purpose.
Yeah.
You remember?
I'll never forget that.
My gosh.
That was the day back in the day where I can run.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's just evil. These kids are so evil.
Yeah, they are until it's it's them.
Yeah,
or someone close to them.
I got called a lot of names.
Yeah.
A lot of names.
Yeah, yeah. We're sorry that you had to go through all that.
I almost say them on the air, but I did get called.
If you wanted to, you could. No, you couldn't.
I got called a lot of names,
But that's just ignorance. You know, that's all it is. It's ignorance. They don't know what it is.
Yeah,
that's all it is.
The one that keeps calling me now, I'm probably doing way better than they are.
Exactly.
It's true. It's true.
I just ignore it and just keep going.
Yeah.
You know.
Well, we're just so proud of you.
My parents always told us one thing, though. Mm-hmm. My parents always told us one thing.
Yes,
that. Don't start a fight, but if they start it,
you better finish it.
You better finish it.
You better finish that.
You're going to finish it.
That's right.
Yeah.
It's true.
Yeah,
and we always finish.
We always finish it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, one time I was in the private school.
Mm-hmm.
One of the classmates, his peers was pushing him to go hit me. He hit me behind his head, behind the head.
Oh my goodness!
That was
it. That was it.
That was a mistake because I was stronger back then.
Right.
Mm-hmm. I picked him up and threw him across the.
Threw
him across the gym.
Oh, no.
I was mad.
We don't condone violence.
I threw him across the gym.
You come for me though. I'm coming for you.
It's just a little birdie in the back of our head that our parents used to always say.
Always.
You better finish it. You better finish. Oh, somebody starts with you.
He never messed with me since. From that day on, he never messed with me.
He became your best friend, I think.
Yeah, he became my best friend.
Yeah.
He didn't think I was going to retaliate.
Uh-huh.
So you never know.
Oh, you never know.
So, I've had a lot of challenges with that.
But, yeah, I'm sure.
You know, we are so proud of you.
Mm-hmm.
Everything that you've done, your strength.
Yeah.
The strength that you have is just, it's just, I mean.
Unbelievable.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
Just so proud of you.
You know, I'm not trying to brag or anything, but I get a lot of everybody that I talk to.
Mm-hmm.
They tell me that they don't believe that I I'm still here and making it. I said, well,
that's
the strength of the Lord that's put
that's
me here.
Right. You got that right.
I just said.
You got that right. But you know, we didn't mention that the doctors only gave you up to 13 years old to live.
Yeah, that was true. That's true. Mm-hmm. My life expectancy was 13. Mm-hmm. Here I am at 55 years old now.
God is good.
So the devil is a liar.
Yes, exactly. Yes, he is. Exactly.
The devil is a liar. So here I am at 55 years old.
Wow. Yeah. Sharp and alert. Yeah.
Hope to see some more. Hope that's to see right. at least 40 more years.
That's right. All right now. I'm going to ask you a tough question, John. I'm going to ask you a tough question.
What's that?
Do you ever say, or have you ever said, why me?
Yeah, that's happened. The majority of the time when that usually happens is when I get picked on a lot.
Still?
Or till this day, I still say it. I mean, till this day, I still say that. That still comes out of my mouth. I shouldn't say it, but I do say it. I say, why me? Why do I have to? Why am I being? I said, why am I being punished like this?
Right.
You know, I said, why am I being punished? But
God knew you were strong enough.
Yeah.
Never give up.
No.
Never give up. So. Mm-mm. So, you know, there's been times I've tried to give up.
I know.
Mm-hmm. You know, I was like, I said, this is more to life than giving up.
Exactly. You can't go out like that. You can't let the devil win.
That's right. You say you come this far by faith, so you just keep going.
Keep going.
You
got
that. Yes. Keep going.
I love it. And we need you, so don't give up. Yeah, keep holding. Keep holding on.
Yeah, some days it's easier said than done.
I know, believe me. Yeah, right. I totally understand.
It's easier said than done. So, yeah. I'm just thanking God for every day that I have, that I see.
Yes. We love you. We love you.
Too.
We're going to leave. Yeah. I'm going to ask you this last question. Did you want to leave the viewers with something regarding your journey or what you've experienced? Or did you want to leave something with them?
Yes, a good word for those that are going through depression or any illness in their life. My word is never give up. Mm. And put your trust in the Lord.
Absolutely.
And if you don't put your trust in the Lord, who else is going to help you? So that's my word to the those that are out there listening. Because I'm still here.
Yes.
As a result of him watching over me, and I'm faithful to him.
Yes.
So never give up. Mm-hmm. That's my word. Yes.
Thank you so much.
Yes, thank you. We appreciate
thank you, for
you
having
coming
me on
out.
The show.
You're welcome. You're welcome. We know this was tough, so we totally appreciate it. Mm-hmm. I know we could go on and on, but we do have to have a certain cutoff point. But next time, what's going to happen is we're going to have you here in the
person.
Studio live.
I'm going to be sitting right there next to y'all.
That's right. That's right. We'll be rejoicing that day. But thank you once again. You know we love you.
Yes.
We love you too. All right. So thank you very much for having me on the show.
Okay. You're welcome. We thank you for joining us this evening, and we appreciate your support. Please tune in next Tuesday at 6 p.m. for another transformational story. In closing, disabled does not mean less abled. Life can be tough for those who are differently abled. John's parents were told that he would not survive past the age of 13 due to hydrocephalus. I can only imagine how traumatizing that is for any parent. They say that a child is only as disabled as their environment and the beliefs of the people around them. John is grateful that our parents did not give up on him. They told him having a disability does not define who you are, and that hard things are put in our way not to stop us, but to call out our courage and strength. We thank you for tuning in to Candid Conversations.
Go. Come on, let's have a candid conversation.